Hello guys, so welcome to our class. So for our midterm, for week module 4, we have objectives or outcomes. At the end of this module, you will be able to first solve problems involving effective rate of interest. Second, solve problems involving annuity. And third, we will analyze problems involving types of annuity. So first, let's tackle about our first topic, which is the effective rate of interest. So what is effective rate of interest? The effective annual interest rate is the real return on a savings account or any interest-paying investment when the effects of compounding over time are taken into account. So, klaro kayo no sa ato ang definition na ang effective rate of interest DI is the real return or nabalik sa ato ang savings account or any interest paying na ato ang giinvest and depende sa effects of compounding over sa ato ang time. It also reveals the real percentage rate owed in interest on a loan, a credit card, or any other debt. It is also called the effective interest rate, the effective rate, or the annual equivalent rate. So, ang effective annual interest rate, pwede po siya matawag nga effective interest rate or the annual equivalent rate. So, in short, effective rate or ER is the actual rate of interest earned on the principal during a period of 1 year. So, we have here our formula sa atoang effective rate or ER. So, ER is equal to 1 plus I raised to m minus 1. Take note sa ato ang formula where kabalo na ta ang I is the interest rate. Ang ato ang m is the mode of compound interest sa ato ang last topic. So, diba, in solving our I, we have here, I is equal to NR. So, ang nominal rate na gihatag sa problem divided by sa M or the mode of compound interest. So, nasabdan ra ang formula. So, let's proceed in our first problem. So, i-apply na to. What effective annual interest rate corresponds to a nominal rate of 8% compounded monthly? So, giingon sa tong problem, naghatag siya. So, first, let's write our given. We have our nominal rate, which is 8% or 0.08. Then, nanghatag po siya M na to, which is compounded monthly. So, for our last topic, sa ito ang prelim, diba, ang ato ang compounded monthly is 12 periods. Since given tanan, we need to substitute our given data sa ito ang formula. So, our formula will be 1 plus I, where ang atong I is nominal rate divided by sa mode of compound interest, which is compounded monthly, raised to the M or the mode of compound interest. So, 12 minus 1. Therefore, ang ato ang effective annual interest rate will be 0.082, or to convert sa percentage times 100, the answer will be 8.29 or approximately to 8.3%. So we have our answer here. So for another example, for our example number 2, if interest is paid at a rate of 5% per year, compounded quarterly, what is the effective rate? So, naghatag siya rate, the nominal rate, which is 5% or equal to 0.05, and our M is compounded quarterly, therefore, for period. Substitute sa ato ang formula. So, we have 1 plus the nominal rate, 0.05 divides atong M, which is compounded quarterly, and raised to 4 since compounded quarterly, minus 1. So, our answer will be 0.0509. So, in percentage, so multiply to 100, the answer will be 5.094%. So, it's very easy since it is a formula-based problems. So, my advice, you need to memorize sa atuang formula. So, proceed ta for another topic. We have continuous compound interest. So, continuous compound interest. Compound interest is interest calculated on the initial principal and also on the accumulated interest of previous periods of a deposit or loan. So, diba, nag-isgot na ta sa atuang compound interest, sa atuang last topic. So, apil siya ang principal and also the accumulated interest sa imuhang deposit or loan. The effect of compound interest depends on frequency. So, here, in continuous compound interest, instead of calculating interest on a finite number of periods, such as yearly or monthly, continuous compounding calculates interest assuming constant compounding over an infinite number of periods. So, giingon dire nga ang continuous di ay nagakalculate siya og interest nga assuming constant ang iyahang compounding over an infinite number of periods na gihatag sa problem. So, in theory for continuous compound interest, it is the rate of increase of money at any time is directly proportional to the amount of money present at any time. So, therefore, ang theory des ato ang continuous compound interest is ang rate sa increase sa imuhang kwarta or money at any time, so directly proportional siya. So, kung mo-increase ang money, mo-increase pud ang amount of money nga present ana nga time. So, we have our formula. So, F is equal to P multiply sa tong E raised to IN. So, what is E? So, where atong E ani is the Euler's. So, makita nato na siya sa tuang calcu. Constant na siya, guys. So, naa siya dire. Kaning shift. Tapad. No. Alpha E. So, we need to use the alpha. Kay, ang atuang shift times 10 is pi di. So, balik ta. So, for our Euler's number, we have alpha, then times 10 raised to x. So, constant number ni siya, guys. So, need lang nato i-input sa ito ang calq. So, F is the future amount. Then, P is the principal or capital amount nga gihatag sa problem. And our I is the annual rate of interest. And N is the number of years. So, same ra siya og meaning sa ato ang last topic from prelim. So, for ER, so sa compounding continuous, napod siya effective rate. If given, na siya E raised to I minus 1. So, take note ta for our formula. If unknown ang ato ang P, then naghatag og future amount. So, we need to derive from our formula here sa atong future amount. So, unknown ang ato ang principal or the capital. So, derive ta P is equal to F. F divided by E raised to I multiply sa ito ang N. So, same process. If unknown. So, unknown ang ato ang principal. So, we need to derive lang since formula base ang ato ang formula. So, we need to apply it sa ato ang example. So, first, we have you deposit $10,000 in a savings account 5 years ago. The account has earned 5.25 interest compounded continuously since then. How much is the account today? So, take note lang ta guys, no, sa ato ang continuous. So, mahibawaan nato siya if unsa to ang gamiton nga formula if naghatag siya sa problem o word nga continuously. So, kabalo na ta. So, formula. Since natay given nga principal which is $10,000 and our interest is 5.25% and our number of years will be 5 years ago. Then, ang unknown nato, how much is the account today? So, ang minana, we have our future amount. So, we need to substitute since given tanan problem, ang data sa itong problem, 10,000 multiply alpha E, the Euler's number constant raised to 0.0525 times the number of years. So, our future amount for compounded continuously will be 13,001.76 US dollars. So, dapat kabalo ta sa ito ang calq since gamit kayo sa ito ang board exam. So, for our next example, so proceed ta since very easy lang atong first example. So, what effective annual interest rate corresponds to a nominal interest rate of 15% per year compounded continuously? So, kanina problem, ma-differentiate na to siya sa effective annual interest na formula sa taas. Ang problem na to, naghatag siya word nga compounded continuously. So, therefore, ang ato ang gamiton nga formula, ang formula sa continuous compound interest. So, diba atong formula, ER is equal to E raised to I minus 1. Since naghatag siya I, which is 15% or 0.15. So, ang ER sa continuous compound interest is given lang ang interest rate. So, substitute. alpha e raised to I, which is 0.15 minus 1. So for our answer for the effective annual interest for compounded continuously, our answer will be 0.1618. So multiply to 100 for percent. So we have 16.18%. So it's very easy since formula based ra tanan ang continuous compound interest. So take note ha sa mga word nga gipanghatag sa problem para i-analyze nato og kabalo ta unsay gihatag or given and the unknown or required. So that will be our last example for our module this week. I hope na ay nasabtan og na ay na learn sa tuang class today. So that's all. Thank you and study in advance.